Hello friend, welcome back to the channel. Hope everybody is doing well. I'm also well. So today is gonna be a different video. It will be a cooking video. Today, another day, I will be sharing with you the one vegetarian recipe. Because I am vegetarian, so I believe to have the vegetarian food. So this is my favorite dish I want to share with all of you. And the ingredients is super easy to get everywhere. This is available in the market. If you want, if you like my recipe, you can try it for dinner, you can try it for lunch, even you can feed the guest also. They will be super happy with your recipe. I definitely can say that. And also, I want to dedicate that recipe to the non-veg people, people who think the vegetable, like people who eat the vegetable, what they eat, what the ingredients they use for. Without onion, garlic, it's possible? Yes, it is possible. Because I believe, if you know how to cook properly, then you can make the taste different. So I will not make you wait, straight go for the cooking. I already have made together all the ingredients. Before I blend them, I want to show you something that what I'm taking for this cooking. So stay tuned. Okay. For our recipe, we need the first ingredients that you can see. This says Veggie Eats, better choice, better life, fried soya nugget imitation meat, so it doesn't have any meat, soybean fiber, soybean protein, wheat protein, soybean oil, salt, vegetarian sizzling, white pepper, black pepper, Chinese five spice, that's it. Okay, so the second and all the ingredients I'm telling you together. Here is some ginger, green chilies, some whole spices like cardamom, cloves and cinnamon. Here is salt. This is paprika, one whole tomato. Here is some cashew and also the potato. I peel the potato off and then I just cut it from the middle, just only two division, not more than that. Okay, so now I will going to open the soya patties from the plastic. Why I didn't open it, I wanted to show you all the ingredients so that it makes so clear that it is not a non-veg thing. This is a vegetarian, full vegetarian, but you won't believe the taste. So you need to try at your home. Okay, let's stay tuned with me. Look at the patties. Exactly, they look like that. People who eat the soya chunks, I can say it is the same ingredients as soya chunk, but the shape is different and taste also little different. So until you try that, you can't say how the taste is. Okay, so I will take all of them for cooking. Now you can see I already take the blender. So first I'm putting here like a teaspoon of cumin powder. A half a teaspoon of coriander powder. A spoon of turmeric, a spoon of salt, all the cashews, the ginger, the whole spices like clove, cardamom, cinnamon. That you can see some of green chilies. Need to put some water and then have to blend. So I forgot to add some tomatoes. Here is all the tomatoes. Now I'm going to blend it.
Thank you.
now for at least 3 minutes I'm going to boil the soya patties to the microwave. The all like entire full cooking I will be doing with a pressure cooker, and here my pressure cooker is already heated up, and I'm going to put sunflower oil. The quantity of the oil is little high. If you want, then you can put the less oil also. And also I cut it the soya chunks, like so not soya chunks, soya patties from the middle. If you want, you can keep them whole like it was before, but I like that way, that's why I cut it from the middle. Going to put some asafoetida, you know, as hing. Now I'm going to fry the soya patties. It's not a deep fry, that's why I put it all together. The oil, you can see, I put very early to the pressure cooker. I'll be doing the entire cooking all this oil. So that's why the quantity of the oil is little high. And then I will be adding more ghee, little ghee later. I have some homemade ghee, my husband has made that ghee, because he has the business. If you guys want to have order some ghee from us, you can tell, because we made organic homemade ghee at our home. Let's fry for 2 to 3 minutes. It's not a deep fry, but when you will fry 2 to 3 minutes, that will be a perfect. So I think it's done. So I'm draining all the oil from the patties, keeping in the glass bowl. As you can see, the rest of the oil still have in the pressure cooker, and at least after 2 minutes I'm going to put some cumin here, whole red chili, 2 bay leaves, some asafoetida. Some clove, coriander, sorry, not coriander, clove and cinnamon. Now I'm putting the potato. The potato don't need to fry, like not deep fried, not need to fry long time. 2 to 3 minutes is enough for them. As you can see, I need the potato like that. I told you, I don't need it too much fry. Remember, I made that blend. Now I am going to put the blend on it. I put some water and put the rest of the masala. It's need little time to cook, and now I will be add some paprika for color. And you see the turmeric salt, everything I added in the blend, so I don't need to put here. In this time, I'm going to add some sambar masala here, just for adding extra flavor. That's also optional. If you don't like it, you can skip it. And at that stage, I need to wait for at least 5 to 7 minutes to cook all the spices nicely. Because until you cook the masala nicely, that the taste will be really, really bad. So I'm waiting to get them, mix them well nicely, so that all the potatoes and the spices mix all together. And I'm coming back after 7 minutes, then I will show you what they exactly look like. Hey, I came back after 7 minutes, and exactly that one is looks like that. You can see the potato and all the oil came up. Now I will be adding all the soya chunks. Oh, why I'm saying soya chunks? Soya patties in it. Cook for 3 to 4 minutes. You can see and in this situation I will be adding more some green chilies, but they are whole. Okay, I didn't break them, just for adding the flavor. If you don't like, you can skip it, that's up to you. Now you can see I came back after 3 minutes, and it looks like it's all the masala is cooked nicely. Now the time I will be adding some ghee, and that's also optional, that you can skip also. I can use the ghee later also. Okay, look, I came back after 5 minutes, and it looks like the masala is already ready, and this is the time I need to put the water on it. Obviously the hot water, not the cold water. The previous cooking I already have mentioned, I never use the cold water for the cooking. So don't waste time, I'm going to put the water in it because it's already ready. I like really juicy, that's why I put little extra water. If you like kind of gravy, you can put water as you like. So now the time, I'm going to off my pressure cooker and wait for one whistle, then it's ready. But before I finish the recipe, I will show you some trick, and it will make the recipe very, very delicious and add some nice smell and flavor. So stay tuned, don't go anywhere. Yes, I came back after one whistle. Now the time to let's see. Yeah, it's done. Come on. Oh. Wow. You can see the color. That exactly came like this. We are almost the final, came to the final. Now I will be adding one more thing, then we will be done. So I'm just placing to the other. Here I take little bit of ghee, which is ghee is purified butter that I told earlier my husband had made it. And then I put some asafoetida, which is hing, known as hing, just for a few seconds. This is the final touch of the recipe, then we will be done. I think I took 15 to 20 minutes around, like pretty much 15 to 20 minutes to finish the cooking. And if you make that recipe, that will go with rice, maybe chapati. And people who doesn't have to rice or chapati either, they can have it with quinoa, dalia, whatever. So it's done. Wait, I want to show you. Just for one more minute. You look, all the potatoes are like this. Yep, we done. Just for 1 minute. So it's time to transfer our dish. Here we go. This is our dish. So finally I have done our cooking. It's all done. That you see, it's take around 15 to 20 minutes to get done the cooking. So I hope you guys enjoy the cooking, and please definitely you have to try at your home and let me know in the comment section how you like the recipe. Till then, ta-ta, bye-bye, love you and take care. And also, before I go, I want to make a request to all of you. If you like my channel, please don't forget to subscribe and also hit the bell on. This is also equally important, you know. If you forget to hit the bell, then you will miss the update from my video. And also one more thing I want to share, please, if you like the recipe, if you like the travel or whatever video I'm posting, please don't forget to put the like. And also keep sharing with the people, then people can join with our family, we can grow together. Till then, tata, bye bye. We will meet with another video very soon. Till then, love you and take care. Bye. Thank you for watching.